اوكي وير لايف برضه هنا على الفيسبوك. رحب معنا دكتور عبد الله حلحولي، دكتور اكرم الطواشي، دكتوره الهام عبد العزيز، دكتوره لبنى ابو الرب، دكتور محمد مهدات، دكتور محمد النذير، دكتور محمد خليفات، معتصم العبد الله مع حفظ الالقاب، دكتوره منى جبريل، دكتورة نانسي السرايرة أهلا وسهلا، دكتور نضال غنام، اس اي عمري ما بعرف مين اس اي عمري، دكتور سامر صناع، دكتورة سليم بدران، دكتور شادي الحوراني، دكتورة سجود فايز، دكتورة زها عمرين، أهلا وسهلا. نرحب ب بدنا نبدأ إن شاء الله هلأ بمحاضرتنا لهذا اليوم. نرحب بالدكتورة عبير الحديدي. الدكتورة عبير الحديدي is an assistant professor at the Department of Oral Surgery and Oral Medicine, Pathology and Periodontology at the School of Dentistry, University of Jordan. الدكتورة الحديدي received her DDS degree 2004 من الجامعة الأردنية and certificate and MS degrees in oral and maxillofacial radiology from the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill ب 2010. She got her PhD ب 2014 من King's College, University of London, completed fellowship and oral and maxillofacial radiology at the University of UNC. اللي احنا already حكينا عنها. اللي هي University of North Carolina طبعا. And she's currently the adjunct assistant professor there. In 2011, Dr. Al-Hadidi became a diplomat of the American Board of Oral and Maxillofacial Radiology. She's also got her Jordanian board certificate, the same specialty. Her research was always focused on the use of 3D data and 3D image analysis in treatment planning of corrective surgical procedures. A PhD was done on the use of 3D image analysis in the diagnosis and treatment planning of mandibular asymmetry. نرحب بالدكتورة عبير الحديدي، أهلا وسهلا فيكي مرة ثانية بجمعية تقويم الأسنان.
يا مساء الورد، يا مساء الورد، الله يعطيكم ألف ألف عافية، وبتمنى إنه أنتوا وعائلاتكم بأحسن حال وأفضل صحة يا رب، وإن شاء الله يا رب يشد وتزول ومنشوف بعض in person قريبا بإذن الله. إذا بتسمحوا لي اليوم I'm gonna go through CBCT application in orthodontics. في البداية رح نحكي شوية عن the basics of the technology، رح نحكي شوية عن بعض التكنيكاليتيز والبيولوجيكال aspects of CBCT that would lend it suitable for dentistry in general or orthodontics in particular. And then we're gonna dive into the position paper of the use of CBCT in orthodontics. و I'm gonna share some cases with you guys عشان نفتح نقاش about and maybe relevance of the use of this technology in the orthodontic practice. So زي ما حضراتكم عارفين الـ CBCT is a technology that is based on a wide cone beam rather than a shallower flat fan beam. It uses an X-ray source. It's a much cheaper, more prevalent, and gives a less dose of radiation as opposed to multi-detector conventional CT scan. And that makes it really significant for dentoalveolar applications. The field of view of CBCT is very flexible as well. وهاي شغلة كتير مهمة. يعني you could actually capture as big as a large field of view, which would have the whole craniofacial area in the field, or you may go with a maxillofacial field of view, هو أصغر شوي, that contains the maxilla mandible. Sometimes this has the TMJ included, sometimes not. Sometimes you may opt into a much smaller field of view where you capture few teeth, and most people that use that would be looking into an endodontic application. فهاي flexibility is very important, especially in orthodontics. فزي ما عم بتلاحظوا, we may look into a large field of view, medium field of view, or a small field of view. بالorthodontics, we're looking into a large and medium field of view being in the major focus. في some technical differences between conventional multi-detector CT and a cone-beam CT that would be relevant in the use of CBCT in the dentoalveolar area. المالتي ديتكتر سي تي would use a fan beam, which means it would take a slice per slice individually. On the other hand, a comb beam CT will use a much larger X-ray source, meaning انت عم تاخد the whole head and neck area in one rotation. وهذه رح نرجع لها in specific, بس نبلش نحكي عن radiation biology with those aspects of the of both technologies. However, image characteristic of CBCT and CT in general could be actually looked at بطريقتين أساسيتين. الطريقة الأولانية هي contrast resolution, والطريقة الثانية هي spatial resolution. الcontrast resolution هي قدرة الimaging system بأنه يحدد the difference between two structures, two types of tissues بناء على the density and thickness تبعهم. وهذه is generally a function of signal to noise ratio. إذا بتطلعوا على هذه السلايد, the signal to noise ratio profile of a multi-detector CT is much better than the signal to noise ratio profile of CBCT, which means in a CBCT has a worse contrast resolution profile. Hello, what does that mean? That means if I'm looking into a radiographic task, an interpretation task, that would necessitate me in يعرف الفرق ما بين two different types of tissues, ما في داعي أخذ كومبين. And I would need that in most soft tissue imaging. إذا عندي soft tissue mass in the tongue أو soft tissue mass inside of a salivary gland أو تفاصيل soft tissue capsule of a temporomandibular joint, then I'm probably not gonna use CBCT. However, one of the major advantages ويعني نقاط القوة في الكومب بيم سي تي هو الريزوليوشن كونتراست تبعه. Resolution contrast is a feature of the imaging technology that would allow me to tell small structures apart even when they're close together. فزي كأنها بتقول لي قديش في تفاصيل أنا بقدر أشوفها بالصورة. وبالكومب بيم سي تي I can actually see more details. Probably most of us in dental specialties would actually need the spatial resolution rather than the contrast resolution, because I want to know تفاصيل الكورتيسيس, تفاصيل علاقة بين التوتال البريدونتال ليجمنت سبيس, إذا عم بحكي عن الستركشرال تشينجز اللي أنا بشوفهم مثلا around a root of a tooth right next to an impacted tooth, أو structural changes be in condylar head, for example. هدول كلهم radiographic tasks that would need spatial resolution, which is great because the CBCT would have the spatial resolution that we need for these tasks. إشي تاني that is also of a major importance in choosing a radiographic technique is the radiation dose. Especially for you guys as orthodontists, لأنه معظم السامبل اللي بتشوفوها, your patients are on the younger side. And definitely you will gonna be even more concerned about radiation dose. هلأ, of course, you would use a higher radiation tool if you need that extra radiation dose, if that dose will actually bring you more important answers about a question. However, if I'm comparing two radiographic modalities that will give me the exact same outcome, I'll definitely will go with the lower dose modality or technology, for example. One way of looking at those is background radiation. هلا إحنا مجرد إن عايشين فوق سطح الأرض أيام ما كنا نسافر من بلد لبلد, the fact that التراب موجود فيه radioactive material, some food that we eat have some radioactive material, إحنا عم نحصل radiation just by being alive. فبال publications لما يحكوا عن radiation dose, مرات they try to equate, you know, how much radiation dose does this modality have in comparison to one day of natural exposure, I would say. For a typical comb beam CT that involves the maxilla and the mandible, that's almost equal to 8 days of background radiation. And in microsieverts, إذا بدنا نحكي شوي technical أكتر, in microsieverts, هدول ما بين 70 to 100 microsievert. بس إذا بدنا نقارنهم ب how many days or how much radiation dose would a CT that involves the same structures اللي هم الماكسل والماندبل هاف, انت عم تحكي عن multiple folds. انت عم تحكي على بين 1000 to 1500 microsievert مقارنة بين 70 و100, وانت عم تحكي عن 256 days أو 170 days of background radiation مقارنة ب 8 days of background radiation depending on قديش الفيلد فيو وwhich machine are we talking about. So if we needed three-dimensional imaging, then comb beam is probably where we need to go. If we do not need three-dimensional imaging, then a panoramic or maybe plus minus acephalometric will be the way to go. And sometimes we may not need imaging for an answer of a clinical task. لأنه for example, a digital panoramic ما بين يعني ال 12 وال 15 microsiever and that's equal to 1.7 days of background radiation. فهي هيك to get a feeling of يعني how much radiation dose am I thinking of giving my patient. Applications of comb beams, the application of any radiation, of any radiology technology that is out there. So implants, driving force, but you know, you use it to any developmental anomaly, impacted teeth, including the third molars as well, periapical endodontic applications, temporomandibular joints, trauma patients, all types of pathological findings, and definitely orthodontics and airway space is one very important clinical use for comb beam CT imaging in the dental practice. There's a very important paper that I usually go by that looked into the clinical recommendations regarding the use of comb beam tomography in orthodontic treatment. And that's a position paper that was written by the American Academy of Oral Maxillofacial Radiology. Half the authors are radiologists, half the authors from orthodontists as well. So there was contribution from the American Academy of Orthodontics in that regard. So they looked at the use of CBCT in all phases of treatment and in multiple scenarios as well. فبالأول زي يعني try to emphasize that زيها زي أي imaging modality تانية the decision to perform that examination needs to be based on the patient's history with clinical examination. إذا المريض عنده previous radiographic imaging, هل في clinical condition معين where you really need extra imaging to be done, and also you need to always outweigh the potential risk of exposure to radiation. Always, always, if you can get your answers, your questions answered by a lower dose conventional imaging, go for it. If you take a panoramic and the panoramic would suffice, then there is no need for comb beam CT. لسه كمان هذه بنحكي فيها أكثر لقدام موضوع الـ virtual orthodontic study models, بس لسه عم بيقول if you can actually perform the task without even ionizing radiation, then أحسن وأحسن. So if you can actually solve your problem, obtain the data without giving your patient radiation, هذا بيكون the ideal situation. تمام؟ هلأ when you decide to use a comb beam, بالذات بالأورثو لأنه we're always dealing with younger people, you kind of have to look into the details and try to minimize the radiation dose, whether you want to optimize the field of view, بلكي minimize the exposure one way or another, and all that. هلا بالنسبة يعني في كتير أشياء that you can control if you work in a hospital base with comb beam جنبك. However, if you're a dentist that is referring out, أحسن طريقة to actually govern هدول الديتيلز هو the choice of the proper field of view. لأنه مش كل مرة مريضك لازم ينبعت عشان يتصور comb beam, you have to include كل الماكسيلا والماندبل أو كل الهيد أنك إيريا. So you probably want to be more specific about what question are you trying to answer, we'll try to limit that field of view لهذيك المنطقة that you're interested in. هلا of course do not take a comb beam just عشان بدك تريح حالك and to get a lateral ceph or a panoramic out of them. وبنفس الطريقة if you really think your patient would need a comb beam وبدك تاخد medium field of view comb beam, ما في داعي تاخد panoramic وcephalometric to start with. يعني إذا أنا مريضي already مثلا craniofacial deformity أو cleft lip and palate patient, I would probably skip the panoramic part and send my patient to get CBCT done, وبعدين get my two-dimensional imaging reformatted from that existing comb beam. حلو. هلا معظم الساينس والإيفيدنس بالليتريتشر على يعني الامبورتنس وال زي ما تقولوا الفائدة من استخدام الكومبيم in the orthodontic patients تقع بالimpacted teeth، لأنه location orientation of those impacted teeth, the morphology of them, relationship to vital structures, path of insertion, والpresence or absence of root resorption of adjacent teeth. أنا تعلمت من زملائي الأرثودونتست إنهم بيلعبوا a major major role in the treatment planning, the prognosis, whether I'm gonna try to bring it in the arch or maybe take it out surgically or maybe just leave it in place and not do anything about it. فهدول ال points اللي عم نحكي عنهم are very important to tackle and very important in the treatment plan, in the overall prognosis of the patients as well. فمعظم كيسات الامباكشن I would say من الليتريتشر ومن الكلينيكال براكتس ومن اللي علموني يا زملائي الأرثودونتست would actually benefit from a combinacity. So whether I'm dealing with complicated cases, multiple supernumeraries, all of them are impacted, such as this example of cleidocranial dysplasia patient, where we have multiple supernumeraries, or some of them may have potentially cystic degeneration around them, or في عنا proximity to a canal. Be clinical situations هيك. There is a lot of decision making to happen. And هون an orthodontist is going to be on board, an oral surgeon needs to be on board. وبالمساعدة الراديولوجيست we're going to have to think about كتير شغلات. We're going to have to think whether we need to leave some of those teeth, if we're leaving any of, if we're taking some out, which ones need to come out, if we're thinking of complete rehabilitation, are we thinking of potential implant therapy later on in life. فكل هاي المعلومات a combi MCT will probably be able to help shed some light to try to solve some of those dilemmas. هلا مرات some of those impacted or even partially impacted teeth, malpositioned teeth maybe, they could appear simpler. يعني for this young lady, كان في عندها buccally placed canine. Yeah, it does not sound, seems to be of a big clinical problem. ولكن طلبوا لها كومبيم for her impacted wisdom teeth. حلو. وبصراحة أنا ما كنت كتير متحمس حتى شفت هذا المنظر. So the root of that buccally displaced canine was devoid of bone. It was all the way out. هلا أكيد كلياتنا بلشنا نصفن في الموضوع إنه this tooth is probably not as easy as you know any orthodontist would say, لأنه يعني it's not gonna take only 9 months if you're gonna even attempt to align it. يعني I'm worried about the vitality of this tooth. I'm worried about the buccal support. Is there gonna be any bone buccal to it? Even if I try to align it, and if I try to align it, would it even stay in place or would it start being mobile? So, يعني في كتير معلومات أعطتني إياها هذه the overall look of the combium that may help me change my mind. طبعاً بعد ما أكون شارح للمريض والguardian تبعه التفاصيل لأنه يعني هذا المنظر would actually help your patient be an active member with team of the decision making. لأنه مرات you really wanna have that conversation ويكون collective decision. فإذا بتسمحوا لي I'm gonna just show few cases of impacted teeth case. Some of these are just regular impacted teeth and some of those are supernumerary. Let's see if يعني, those combiums were helpful or not. So these are a couple of supernumerary teeth that are situated right palatal to both central incisors. حيكون ببال الواحد multiple questions. أولاً, situation of the impaction. How close are those teeth to the roots of the central incisors? True situation of the roots of the central incisors من ناحية development, من ناحية closure of the roots, من ناحية shape as well. Are any of these roots dilacerated or not? And this is a volume rendering model. هذا بعطيني هيك an overall look of maybe relationship, overall look about the morphology of teeth as well. ولكن أنا when I go over and see my combiums, I actually use the actual data. On this upper right corner over here, I see an axial cut. And then this is correlated by a reconstructed panoramic and I can see a bucolingual perspective of those supramammary teeth. Now I can tell, are they close to the roots of the natural teeth? I can tell if what's the nature of the roots of those supernumeraries, and I can tell whether the roots of the natural teeth have been affected by external root resorption or something like that. And so if you see that the upper one is looking at the upper left central and the associated supernumerary, and we can see below the same representation of the supernumerary on the right-hand side. See a couple of supernumeraries on the mandible as well, you know, with the mandible having the ID canal and the mental foramen. Also, relationship to vital structure comes handy because, you know, after we decide whether these teeth are to stay or to go, we'll probably want to look into surgical approach, whether, you know, maybe a different surgical technique needs to happen, whether that patient may need more than local anesthesia during the operation. So we look into these teeth. And again, this is the axial cut, and this is correlated with the reconstructed panoramic. And I would like to ألفت نظركم للخط البرتقالي هون that corresponds with الأكسل كات أب هير والخطوط الخضر الكونزيجاتيف هدول they correspond with the specific cross sections that we see on الطرف اللي على اليمين تمام. The numbers that are up here they correspond on the numbers اللي جايين على الأرش because the arch كمان مرقم زي كأنه مرقم مسطرة ومعظم السوفتويرز will give us that sort of correlation لأنه يعني بال 3D imaging في more data than we usually see or encounter on our panoramic or regular cephalometric فwe always have to keep coordinated عشان not to lose our geographic location عشان الواحد not to get confused على أنا وين بطلع وين بكل وين palatal so you always wanna try to correlate كل the views مع بعض. And this is a good look of the supernumerary teeth on the left hand side. This is the volume rendered from an occlusal perspective. This is giving us one side and this is looking at the other side. So proper characterization of where their teeth are and their relationship to adjacent teeth and to vital structure. This is another example of an impacted canine. Also, how much buccal bone there is, برضو has been a very important prognostic factor. And that probably will change your decision on the mechanics used. And whether you know more bodily movement needs to happen, وكل هاي التفاصيل التقنية اللي حضراتكم تعرفوا فيها أكثر مني بكثير. Also, زي ما اتفقنا, the presence of a potential external root resorption on adjacent teeth would also بيأثر على البروغنوسيس وبيأثر على الميكانيكس as well. So هون close-up عم بيورجينا intermediate, I would say, external root resorption that is affecting the buccal surface of the root of the lower left lateral incisor. Tamam, and this is the volume rendered appearance of that buccally impacted canine in almost transposition as well. This is another look into another supernumerary and associated impacted teeth. Also the relationship of those supernumerary teeth and impacted teeth to the nose are usually interesting as well because that's, يعني, it may need a slight change in the surgical technique as far as accessibility to that. أخيراً وليس آخراً, sometimes impacted teeth are associated with pathology. يعني هم ما بيكونوا impacted because of space issues أو because of root morphology problems. لا, بيكونوا being impeded, physically impeded from actually erupting. And this is a good example of an odontome. This is a complex odontome to me. And that explains why that second molar failed to erupt. So ما ننسى إنه يعني our patients can actually have diseases that we may need to be able to figure out looking at a three-dimensional image. Other things that are important are craniofacial deformities, including cleft lip and palate and all the other syndromes that you guys sometimes see in clinic. We have a lot of softwares and a lot of effort in technology that actually trying to provide more tools for us to be able to, I would say, deduct more info from our three-dimensional image. Because, you know, looking at the cone beam is very, very useful. However, if we can detect more information, whether about the morphology of the head and neck areas of the patient, or whether something has to do with the soft tissue as well, that would probably be an added benefit to our patients, especially if we go into the orthognathic surgery kind of world. So there are multiple softwares that would have additional three-dimensional cephalometric capabilities, Dolphin 3D being one of them, and it helps into, you know, having all those modules that looks into the temporomandibular joint and maybe an orthognathic surgery type of module. Materialized also has those modules that go in the intersection between orthodontics and surgery with all those reconstructed work and, you know, all those syndromic patients, which actually may be useful. And that goes into the digital dentistry world with, you know, designing and printing missing pieces or intermediate tools, I would say, in the treatment plan. Virtual study model has been kind of one of those interesting things that we can detect out of a cone beam. I personally have a lot of reservations in this particular use, I would say, because of two reasons. Number one, if some people بلشوا ياخذوا كوم بيم كجزء من convenience, يعني انت you get a كوم بيم بعدين بتطلع منها virtual study model, بتطلع منها panoramic, بتطلع منها كوم بيم, وللأسف scientifically هذا مش good enough reason. ف it has been, زي ما تقولوا, misused. Also, on the other hand, I have much better alternatives of getting a virtual study model, which is intraoral scanning. هلا intraoral scanning would give me a much better quality بالستدي موديل, quality بتكون أحسن, using zero radiation. فI would probably personally would rather إنه أستعمل better quality with zero radiation. هلا, however, if my patient really needs a cone beam, وأنا أخذت الكون بيم for a valid reason, ما عندي مشكلة إنه to try to look into this as an extra benefit, بس مش السبب الرئيسي أو أعتمد عليها اعتمد على الكون بيم عشان اطلع virtual study model. So that's one thing to consider. A cone beam could actually be زي ما تقولوا base عشان انا اركب عليها other clinical input, زي مثلا 3D photography, وهذا بيساعد بال انه يعني ادخل treatment planning of the soft tissue on top of the heart tissue, bone and teeth underneath. So you can always merge a cone beam CT with a 3D photograph, extraoral and intraoral as well. لأنه I can also take an intraoral scan and merge it with my cone beam as well. فهذا ممكن يكون useful. Those third party softwares will actually be able to deduct a lateral or a PA cephalometric radiographs from the cone beam data set, if needed, of course, and if the cone beam was called for in the first place, for sure. Sometimes cone beam could be useful. I know a lot of people would say, "Mini screws, عبير, not really. It's such an easy thing to do. Maybe I don't want to إني أعرض مريضي خاصة for young people." I totally agree with you. But if you're using a plate, مثلا, if there is something interesting regarding the root morphology, أو ال يعني shape of that arch, يعني something that is شوي out of normal, there are numerous articles بال literature عم تحكي عن potential use of cone beam if you're thinking about extra anchorage that is derived from the bone, عشان تعرف وين تحطها ويعني ما تعمل damage to adjacent structures, for sure. Airway assessment has always been interesting. يعني إذا بلشنا نقرأ literature قبل 10 سنين مثلا, there was a huge drive about let's dive more and look more into the morphology of the airway, the volume of the airway, the cross-section of the airway. There was a lot of effort into trying to combine that with potential sleep apnea signs and symptoms, maybe with potential morphological facial profiles. وهذا الحكي يعني عم بتطور, يعني every now and then بتبلش في groups جديدة عم تشتغل عليه. صراحة literature مش متفق, يعني you may read a lot of pieces that would say this particular feature could be connected, or you would hear a really good group, nice piece of literature on the other hand that would give you contradicting sign. I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying do not take a comb beam just to look into your airway assessment. If you already have a comb beam for other features, or you were scrolling through it and you notice that the cross section is really small in some area, then we probably want to maybe look closely and look into all the other features of the airway. ولكن just for airway assessment, ما في literature كفاية يقول أخذ comb beam. بس for that sole reason. هلأ بالزمانات أيام ما أنا كنت أشتغل الماجستير والكومبيم تبعي كنا نعمل هذا الحكي باليد, يعني تسمي automatic kind of a research point of view. بس هلأ there are a lot of tools that can actually give you that in a much much easier chairside type of way. فيعني التولز كلها في متناول اليد, بس we probably have to be a little bit more diligent in I would say interpreting the results. This is really really interesting. وجود الكوم بيم والuse of the كوم بيم عم بعطينا a golden opportunity into actually understanding growth and development أكثر. وأنا عارف يعني you guys are the perfect group عشان to share my passion in growth and development. عشان ما حدا بفهم ليش أنا بكون مبسوطة وأنا عم بطلع على السينكوندروسس إلا أنتوا جماعتي, جماعة الأورثو. So yeah, we could tell a lot more about our understanding of growth and development, and تعلمنا كتير 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 من الكوم بيمز على الأورثوغنوثيك سيرجري. يعني كل الليتريتشر تبع الريلابس والستابيليتي of orthognathic احنا عم يعني اخذناه من كوم بيم سي تي. And I'm saying that because I was يعني honored to be part of the stability study following orthognathic surgery, which was a really really long term process that happened at the University of North Carolina Chapel Hill. ورحمة الله عليه William Prophet was the head of that working group, ودكتور Phillips Seep Phillips has carried over after as well. So you know, to really get that true three dimensional follow up. Then we've always been really smart. نستعيد عن the true three dimensional built 2D cephalometrics, which is صراحة much very very clever way of doing it. But if you really have the real 3D data, that will actually give you more chance to really understand what's going on. So now we can look about global changes, specific changes, what happens to the TMJ, what happens to the chin, what happens to the nose, you know what I mean? And talk about it in a heart tissue level with soft tissue level as well. Tamam. But we can just look at it and do some visualization and quantification, just overlay after, before, أو بعد السيرجري بسنتين وبعد السيرجري بخمس سنوات أو بعمر كذا وبعمر كذا. But this is one way of doing it. And these are examples that are dedicated from a publication by Lucia, Dr. Savidanis. And here they're looking at three-dimensional changes in the maxilla, for example, in maxillary advancement and mandibular setback surgery. So see, we have those color-coded maps that would reflect on bone and that would reflect on soft tissue. إذا بتلاحظوا تحت في عنا millimeters, فأنا I know how much. وفي عنا colors where blue معناته resorption وred معناته advancement, and I have direction as well. تمام؟ وthat's only the beginning, because زي ما اتفقنا I can do that على global وI can do that على local. تمام؟ And these are few examples of how can I do that on a temporomandibular joint, for example? وهذه is another way of characterization. يشوفوا كيف عم يتغير حجم هذا الكوندايل، عم يتغير long axis x axis تبعها. Even those poles are changing shapes, there's changing location as well. وهذا الاشي عم بيعلمنا كتير كتير on how the body reacts to what we do as orthodontists and as orthognathic surgeons as well. تمام. We could actually do more. We can actually take every specific point on that surface, let it be mandible, maxilla, cranial base, condyle, اللي بدي اياه. وكل point اقدر اعطيها الدايركشن والمقدار والماجنتيود as well. وهذا is a good example يعني of الفلو كيف بيمشي. يعني انت بتاخد الكومبيم سي تي and you do your segmentation, meaning انه انت بتستخرج الماكسيلا او الماندبل او whatever structure انت عم تدرسه. بعدين you do registration لانه انت بدك تقارن point A point B, بدك تقارن يمين بالشمال. وبس تختار two objects بدك تقارن فيهم بتبلش تشتغل الفانسي ماث تبعك وبتبلش تحدد مقدار واتجاه. تمام. These are examples. إذا بتلاحظوا هون هلأ بورجيكم تفاصيل أكثر. هدول الـ irregularities, الأسهم اللي طالعة, هدول vectors that would tell you إنه الماندبل الجري هون فرقوا عن الماندبل المارون هون على كل نقطة من النقاط هي هالقد مليمتر في ذلك الاتجاه. تمام. فهذه is the general surface map. هذه is a surface map بالألوان عشان تقدر تقول لي اتجاهات إنه البون عم بيروح ولا البون is being deposited. وبعدين هذه بتعطيني the specific vectors of where this exact piece of bone has changed and أو how much difference there is between those two particular surfaces. إذا بقرب لكم إياهم شايفين كيف إنه هدول بعض الأسهم عم تطلع برا السيرفس وبعض الأسهم actually عم تدخل جوا السيرفس وبعض الأسهم عم بتكون كيرفي لينير. وكل هاي طبعا إلها mathematical way of looking into it وإلها statistical measures. وبالآخر ببلشوا يقولوا لنا إنه والله mandibular setback is the least stable surgery for example, أو this is a way of looking into mandibular asymmetric patients. لأنه when I have all this data, what I can do is actually design الكونترالاترال سايد كيف بدي اياه وبعدين بطبع فيرتشوال موديل وبعدين اي بري بند ماي ريكونستراكشن بار. فبصير انا كجراح بدل ما اقضي 5 ساعات وانا تراينج تو بند اند بري بند بيكون في عندي سم سورت اوف ا درافت تو اكشلي ورك وذ انترا اوبراتيفلي. فذوز ثينجز مي سيم هيك تو سكولرلي اي وود سي بس ذي ار فيري فيري كلينيكلي فاليد أو يعني إلهم استخدامات كلينيكال فور شور. تمام. فزي ما اتفقنا أنا ممكن أعمل إشي جلوبال وممكن هون إذا بتلاحظوا أنا بس مركز على اللاترال بول أوف ذا كوندايل لأنه بدي أعرف بس هاي التفصيلة. تحت مثلا أنا مركز على الريمس أوف ذا ماندبل and also I have a scale that goes من هالقد مليمترز لهالقد مليمترز. وأكيد كل كلينيكال تاسكس بتفرق على يعني how much change am I looking into. You can definitely do something like that with teeth and movement of teeth. This is a very excellent book. I think it would be a fun book if you are into combeam tomography. بيقول combeam computed tomography in orthodontics, indications, insight, and innovation. And it's coming out of the University of Michigan. I did have a pleasure of authoring one of the chapters behind the book. And I think it may be a good read if you want to know more about يعني how combeam tomography, the basic tomography and all the analysis of tomography could be useful in routine everyday orthodontic patients. And this is what I have for you guys, and I'll be more than happy to listen to questions and hear insights or any advice that you guys may have for me. Thank you.
شكرا دكتورة عبير. يعني very nice lecture. راح نفتح هلا ال Q&A. لأن بال Q&A دكتورة تحبي أنت تشوفيه ولا تحبي أنا أقرأ لك إياهم؟
والله إذا بتقرأ لي إياهم ممتاز عشان أنا ما أسرح.
أوكي تمام. عندنا دكتور سامر صناع، أهلا وسهلا صديقنا العزيز
تحياتي
دكتور
زعيم.
سامر. أول سؤال، you know what I might be able، خليني شوف. طيب anyway I will read، كنت بدي أخليك أنت تحكي let me see، I want to put you live ما دام معنا وقت. Participants، هاي الدكتور سامر.
هلا وسامعيني هاي؟ يعطيك العافية دكتورة، يعطيك العافية دكتورة أستاذي وجميع كلكم. Lovely lecture as always، ما شاء الله عليك.
Thank you.
My question، there's a comment and then there's a question for you please.
Yes sir.
Now the comment is, in the world of orthodontics today, there is a push towards customized and digital orthodontics. And by customized meaning we're trying to يعني scan every patient, trying to model certain treatments على الفايلز اللي بتطلع من السكان إلى آخره.
Yes sir.
And this is not very new, but what is more recent is the introduction of roots within that system. So softwares تطلع that will lay over the roots from a cone beam to the crowns from a scanner. And my question to you is, if this is going to become mainstream, of course, تحفظك على the high radiation dose is accepted. But في some machines بدعوا إنه low radiation is as little as a panoramic or a couple of panoramics. So what are your thoughts on this one, the radiation dose, if this is going to become a mainstream in orthodontics? And number two, you've mentioned the virtual study model. To use the information from the cone beam to kind of like replace a scanner if we needed that cone beam anyway.
Yes.
So is the file that's generated, are the information accurate for us to fabricate something or just to visualize it?
Excellent questions. إذا بتحب خليني أبلش بquestion number two. هلا it really depends on two things. It depends on the resolution of the cone beam that is taken. لأنه the smaller field of view, the smaller pixel size, the higher resolution, probably you've got a better shot at getting a better virtual model. هلا إذا عم نشتغل regular اللي هي 0.2 ل 0.4 millimeters of pixel size, I would not be too excited about fabricating anything from that virtual model. خاصة إنه يعني ال intraoral scanners are much better, they're far cheaper, and they're far more reliable. إن في data كفاية على intraoral scanners. So that's my take as far يعني من القراءة اللي قرأتها. هلا as far as your very first question, this is fascinating صراحة, very very exciting. وهذا الشغل يعني زي ما قلت حضرتك دكتور سامر مبلش من زمان يعني they've been talking about it من لما أنا كنت graduate school and they've been putting so much effort. هلا الحلو بهذا الجزء إنه بلشنا نحكي بالأورثو بالذات على big data. كيف يعني big data؟ يعني لأنه ناس عم تعمل intraoral scanning على multiple nice intervals. If you were looking about a pre-operative and all the way at the end is عندك two cone beams, واحدة بأول treatment, واحدة بآخر آخر treatment, we may be able to actually يعني نطلع بالgorithms تخلينا يعني نصير نفهم الأورثو أكثر, نصير نفهم why teeth move the way they do, why teeth move as fast as they do. لأنه أنتوا عارفين يعني الأورثو بتطول وقتاً لأنه some stuff are harder to explain. يعني sometimes you wanna try something وبعدين you have to go another way. فهو لربما إحنا يعني هلأ بمرحلة تجميع الداتا I think you know some of it is valid, especially if I'm having a kid with an impacted tooth أو لأنه maybe is يعني إن شاء الله بعد 10 سنين حنقعد مع بعض نقول تتذكري أيام كنا نحكي هيك, حتكون already هاي الداتا مجمعة وصار في database where we actually will have to look at features 1 2 3 وبتعطينا indication outcome حتكون هيك versus هيك. هلا أنا بعرف هذا كله لسه حكي بس يعني I'm hearing from multiple groups that are working on this بأمريكا وكذا وشغل بصراحة كتير 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 حلو. أنا I truly think إنه هذا حيغير الأورثو كتير. مش عارف if it's good or bad, بس maybe يعني هذا the only disadvantage تبعه إنه الناس اللي ما عندها كتير خبرة بالأورثو ممكن تصير تتجرأ تشتغل أورثو, which is probably the worst thing ever. ولكن at least يعني عرفت كيف we're cultivating هاي الداتا ونجمع كل هاي المعلومات. بس fascinating هذا الإشي, أنا متأكد حنشوف كتير أشياء فيه في المستقبل اللي مش بعيد.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
شكرا دكتور سامر. في حدا بيحب يسأل أسئلة؟ Any questions؟
دكتور عبير.
تفضل دكتور شادي.
دكتور عبير, thank you so much لهال valuable presentation الحقيقة. Very informative and very nice, very easy to understand. صراحة في شوية questions يمكن مش عندنا هون على الزوم, عم بلاحظهم على الفيسبوك, فحابة
على الفيسبوك.
Of course, please.
One of the questions is, can we use CBCT with intravenous contrast as conventional CT for more soft tissue details? This is one question.
It's a very interesting question. كثير ناس عم أنا أسف تفضل.
لا تفضلي.
حمست.
لا هذاك سؤال ثاني. نرجع نسأل.
أوكي, هني أجاوب هذا السؤال إذن. هلا كثير في ناس فكروا بهاي الفكرة, بس هو الانترافينوس كونتراست يوجوالي بده هوسبيتال سيتنج, لأنه انتو عارفين الكونتراست is one of those, it's a drug, you may have allergy to it, you may need to look into kidney function test. يعني هاي مو اشي يقدر دكتور سنان يعمله بعيادته. هل فبيني وبينك يعني اليوز اوف انترافينوس كونتراست كتير ليميتد, خاصة انه انا ما عندي يعني soft tissue كونتراست, لأنه ما هو soft tissue مش كلها بتاخد الكونتراست بنفس الليفل. فهي it's a nice idea, بس it's not a clinically feasible idea. هلا في ناس مثلا بتورنتو, University of Toronto, شو حاولوا يسووا, حاولوا يستعملوا الكونتراست يحطوها كسيالوغرافي, يحطوها بال inside of the parotid gland tree على اساس يشوفوا for obstructive problems including calculi وهيك اشياء salivary gland stone. يعني فيعني contrast material in general have been used in salivary glands زي كأنها سيلوغرافي, بس لحد الآن ما في clinical value لليوز as an intravenous medical CT.
حلو, excellent, thank you. And the second question, the second question was, is it safe in pregnancy?
هلا الفكرة ال pregnancy, that's an excellent question, thank you for bringing that up. هلا ال bad effect of radiation جماعة مقسومة إلى قسمين, في stochastic effect وفي deterministic effect. stochastic effect هي الإفكت التي ما بتحتاج لليفل معين, ما في إلها cut off point. deterministic effect في إلها cut off point, يعني إذا وصلت الراديشن لهون بيصير الإفكت, تحتيها بشوي ما بيصير الإفكت. هلا effect on fetus هو deterministic effect, الحمد لله رب العالمين. فكمية الراديشن اللي لا سمح الله ممكن تأثر على الفيتس وتعمل bad effects, يعني زي ما تقول يعني إحنا كدنتست ما بنقدر نوصل لها, يعني هي بدها زي ما تقول 30 ضعف الفول ماوس سيريز. هلا الكومبيم, معظم الكومبيمز أقل من الدوز تبعت الفول ماوس سيريز, ولكن يعني أنا في عندي the devil's advocate, النص الثاني من الجواب. Why am I taking a combium on a pregnant lady? هلا if I'm يعني إذا هو السبب لأنه أنا بدي أعالجها, يعني هي trauma patient وعندها mandibular fracture لا سمح الله, طبعا أخذ لها combium. بس والله أخذ لها combium عشان عندها impacted canine, يمكن مش وقته, وجهة نظري from يعني زي ما تقول برضو a patient management point of view. ولكن إذا يعني هاي الكومبيم ضرورية in the immediate management of the patient, then نعم, go ahead and take a combium.
Fair enough. Thank you. Thank you very much. دكتور عدلي, I think you're unmuted. إذا بتحب تسأل تفضل.
يعطيك العافية دكتورة عبير, المحاضرة رائعة.
كلك ذوق.
الله يسلمك. دكتورة عبير, حكيت عن الـ extraction of SIF and OPG from CBCT. سؤالي, how accurate or how is it feasible to extract standardized lateral SIF from cone beam CT?
هلا ما هون الفكرة, هذه مش lateral SIF لأنه هذه ما فيها magnification. عارف شو قصدي؟ فهذه بتطلع an unmagnified, يعني you don't have to correct for it.
This is for linear measurements. That's okay. Okay, but for angular, no problem. تمام. طب أنا
وحتى باللينير لأنه إحنا معظمنا we correct for the magnification.
يعني إحنا بالأورثو عادة صار يعني نأخذ اللينير without correction غالبا يعني.
أوكي. حلو.
بس أنا سمعت كثير حتى من الأطباء اللي هو مو أورثو حتى الإمبلانتولوجيست بيقول لك بدي CBCT وبدي OPG لأنه أنا الOPG بتعطيني معلومات غير عن حتى الOPG اللي extracted. ليش؟
أحكي لك ليش. لأنه we are all victims of our training. أنا كعبير الحديدي لما كنت undergraduate student بصراحة ما عمري شفت كومبي. فإحنا we feel safer if we look at a panoramic. عشان هيك مثلا أنا حتى عبير الحديدي اللي هي radiologist أنا بشوف كومبيمز for a living. This is what I do all day. أول ما بطلع على MPR view اللي هو axial sagittal coronal وبس أخلصهم I go and I create my panoramic. لأنه again بتساعدني أعد أسنان، بتساعدني أشوف الparallelism of roots، يعني عرفت كيف بترجعني لملعبي إشي أقرب لإشي أنا متعود أشوفه. ولكن حقيقة البانوراميك ما في إشي تضيفه على الكومبيم من ناحية يعني معلومات حقيقية، هي يعني البرسبكتيف تبعها مميز نعم. ولهذا always اعمل بانوراميك من الكومبيم، يعني ما في viewing software إلا فيه بانوراميك تاب. عرفت شو قصدي؟ بس لو أنا محلك ما باخد لمريضي كومبيم and a panoramic. لا والله دكتور، يعني respectfully disagree.
Okay. Regarding superimposition, what is the best software to do that? And is there something free?
هلأ the best softwares are the free softwares actually. بس يعني ما هو سبحان الله قلت الأمريكان no free lunch. فالفري سوفتويرز بياخذوا وقت، they are labor intensive. يعني اذا بتسمحوا لي مثلا هذا كله السوبر امبوزيشن اللي ورا، هذا كله انا اشتغلته بفري سوفتويرز هدول كلهم دوك. بس مثلا انا عشان اعمل اكستراكشن اوف اول ذا ماكسيلامانديبل اند كرينيال بيس اوف وان بيشنت، اعمل سيجمنتيشن لو وان بيشنت تاخذني يعني جود 4 اورز. عرفت شو قصدي؟ هلأ في softwares تعمل هذا الحكي أسرع for sure، بس هدول fully dedicated وبصراحة expensive piece of software. فإذا أنت يعني بتشتغل بمكان كتير بيشتغل digital dentistry، تعرف هدول المستشفيات اللي دائماً بيعملوا reconstructive surgeries وما بيشوفوا غير craniofacial deformities وعندهم printers وكل هاي الأشياء، it's worth it. بس بعيادة أو حتى عندي بمستشفى مش يعني بس بركز على هدول، أنا I use those free software. هلأ هدول الحلو فيهم الفري software برضو، يعني أنا عارف من هن جايين، يعني هدول are being supported by an NIH grant، فهم مجموعة جامعات جدا محترمة بأمريكا 5-6 وبحطوا كل الأشياءهم بمكان معين بحيث الريسيرشرز والكلينيشنز يقدروا to access هدول التولز. وفي يعني في سبورت كتير حلو وفي فيديوز تعلمك كيف تعملهم، بس هم للأسف بدهم شوية وقت.
طب في دينا أعطينا إحنا والزملاء هيك بعضهم، خلينا أو السايت اللي ممكن نأخذ منه.
Slicer 3D is a good place to start. Slicer 3D.
Slicer 3D.
Slicer.org. في إشي اسمه Slicer CMF. كرينيو ماكسيلوفيشل. سلايسر سي ام اف عظيم للاشياء السوبر امبوزيشن.
شكرا
يا ميت، اهلا وسهلا. ودوله مينو اذا بتحب نقدر نتواصل برضه اذا حضرتك يعني مهتم بالايمج اناليسيس وبنقدر نحكي تفاصيل اكثر فور شور.
ان شاء الله. تسلمي، شكرا.
بقول لك لو
في حدا بحب يسال اني كويستشنز. دكتور عبير بدي أسألك بليز، الكتاب اللي حكيتي لنا عنه موجود على PDF digital format ولا it's only؟
أنا عندي إياه إذا بتحب أبعث لك إياه، أنا عشاني أوثر فبيغوزوا معي فبعثوا لي إياه فبقدر أبعث لك إياه. شور.
أوكي، بس هو it's not for publishing يعني.
هلأ يعني for scientific use إذا إحنا بنستعمله بالجمعية ما في مشكلة لأنه أنا أوردي ماخذ إذن.
أوكي، يعني it's not open for everyone.
أبزر. فهو بس يعني within الجمعية ما أظن حيكون في مشكلة. دكتور كابيلا is such a very nice guy.
طيب أوكي. This is one question. أي أسئلة تانية للدكتورة عبير؟ أوكي. قبل ما ننهي اللقاء بدي أشكر أول شيء جميع الزملاء الموجودين واللي بيحضرونا كمان على الفيسبوك. في بدي أذكر الجميع في بكرة محاضرة للجمعية السعودية لتقويم الأسنان Importance of Early Orthodontic Treatment Prevention with Clear Aligner Therapy. هذه راح تكون free. راح ننزل إحنا اللينك بعد شوي تبعها. وبرضو في كتير من الزملاء سألوني راح نداوم إحنا يوم الأحد أو ما راح نداوم. مبدئياً لهلأ ما في أي جواب من معالي وزير الصحة إذا في دوام أو لا. الخبر راح يطلع من دائرة الأزمات. فwe will stay tuned for it. طبعاً أنا بحب أحث جميع الزملاء اللي بده يداوم نمشي على البروتوكول بليز تبع النقابة اللي حطت لنا إياه. ما بدنا أي mistakes تطلع من طرف أخصائيين التقويم ونكون إحنا أول ناس to be blamed for it أو أي حالة تطلع من جهة أخصائيين التقويم أو عيادة تقويم أسنان. وبتمنى برضو من الزملاء أخصائيين التقويم اللي بيشتغلوا برضو general dentistry إنه يعني بس للحالات الطارئة بليز خلينا بغنى عن هذا الموضوع لحد ما تصير الأمور عنا كلير وسير إن شاء الله. الإشي الثاني برضو راح أبعت أنا لينك بعد شوي على مجموعة الواتساب أي أخصائي تقويم بحب ينضم لصفحة الأرب أورثودونتيك سوسايتي he can join, answer the questions we will approve him. المهم يكون أخصائي تقويم مسجل في جمعية تقويم الأسنان الأردنية والفكين ومسدد اشتراك. بدي أشكر مرة ثانية الدكتور عبير الحديدي. شكراً جزيلاً على محاضرتك القيمة اليوم. شكراً. إن شاء الله بشوفك in better circumstances.
آمين يا الله.
شكراً جميعاً.
شكراً جزيلاً.
أصبح على خير. نشوفكم على خير يا الله. السلام عليكم.
سلام. شكراً. شكراً.
مع السلامة.
سلام. سلام.
Okay. We will end the meeting now. يعطيكم العافية.
السلامة. الله يعطيكم العافية.
الله يعطيكم.